EBS snapshots are a way that we can create backups of our EC2 instances or of our EBS volumes. So a snapshot is a point in time copy of your EBS volume. So here we have an availability zone with an instance, and that instance is connected to an EBS volume. So you can create a snapshot. Now the snapshots themselves actually live on S3, which means they're in the region, not in the availability zone. Now, snapshots can be taken incrementally. So you take snapshot A, and then you make some changes to your volume. You can then take snapshot B. Now, snapshot B will only reflect the changes to the volume since snapshot A, so it's an incremental backup. And then you take snapshot C. Even though snapshot B and C are incremental, so they only have the changes since snapshot A, they themselves can be used to restore your volume. So you actually only need to retain the most recent snapshot, so in this case, snapshot C, if you want to restore the volume. So sometimes you see exam questions where you need to reduce the amount of space that's being used on Amazon S3 to save money. And the answer would be that you only need to keep C. So you don't need to keep A, you don't need to keep B or any others in the middle. Always just keep the most recent snapshot, and AWS are smart enough that they can work that out and they make sure that no data is lost. Now, one of the things you can do with a snapshot is create a volume in another availability zone. So because the snapshot is in S3, you can then create a volume in a different AZ because S3 is obviously accessible from any availability zone. So this is a way that you can actually move a volume from one availability zone to another. You create a snapshot, and then you restore the snapshot to create a new volume in that other availability zone, and then you can attach that to an instance in that AZ. So what we're going to do in this lesson is do a bit of a hands-on. We're going to have our EC2 instance in one availability zone with a volume, and we're going to create a snapshot, and then from that snapshot, we're going to create an AMI. So remember that an AMI is an Amazon machine image, and you use AMIs to launch your EC2 instances. So it's actually backed by a snapshot with a root EBS volume on it. So what we're going to do is create that AMI, and then from the AMI, we'll create a new EC2 instance with an EBS volume, and that EBS volume will be identical to the EBS volume here attached to this original instance. So it's a way of creating an identical copy of that EC2 instance in another AZ. So I'm in the console now, and the way that we're going to create our Amazon machine image is firstly, we need to take a snapshot of our volume. So in this case, we're going to take our original GP2 volume. So that's the root operating system. We're not taking the data disk in this case. And I'm going to create a snapshot, and we can give it a description if we want to, and we can just click on create snapshot and then click on close. And then if I go to snapshots, we've got one that's pending. So that shouldn't take long because there's not a huge amount of data on that drive, but that'll take a couple of minutes, and then that will be ready for us to create our AMI from. The first thing we need to do is actually create a snapshot of our instance. And then from the snapshot, we're going to then create our AMI, which we can use to launch an instance in another AZ. Now, note that in this particular instance, my availability zone is 2B, so we'll move to 2C. Now, the first thing I need to do to make sure that I capture an application consistent backup is I'm going to have to shut down this OS. Now, that's because I'm doing snapshotting straight through EBS. If you want to take application consistent snapshots with Windows without shutting down your operating system, you can do so, but you need to use the system manager run command, which is something we'll look at in the next section. So for now, what I'm going to do is just shut down my instance. That's stopped now, so let's go down to volumes. And what we're going to do is select our GP2 volumes. Remember, this is our boot volume. This is our root EBS volume. I'm going to click on actions, create snapshot. I'm not going to leave a description, just click on create snapshot. And let's click on close. So now if we go to snapshots on the left here, we'll find that this is pending, and this will take a few minutes to create. And once it's finished, we'll then be able to create our AMI. So that didn't take long at all, probably 30 seconds. Let's click on actions, and what we want to do is click create image. So create image creates an AMI. And we can give this a name. I'm just going to call it my AMI. And then there's various parameters we can change here, including, again, you have the option to change what type of volume you're going to use. You can also change the termination attribute. Notice that this volume is not encrypted, and there isn't a way to create an encrypted volume. You can also add a volume. So if you wanted to add a volume, you can do that here. And in that case, you can choose to encrypt that volume. So the key point there is if your volume snapshot is not encrypted, when you create a AMI from it, you can't change the status to encrypted. So I'm going to leave all these defaults and just click on create. Let's click on close and then go to AMIs on the left here. So now we have an AMI available. So why don't we launch from it? I click on launch. I click on general purpose T2. It already knows what the AMI is because we're launching from the AMI. Click on next. Again, we could change things like the delete on termination attribute here or the volume type, but I'm going to leave those defaults. So now we have our AMI. It's available. It's a private AMI, so it's only visible to us in our account. Now you can share AMIs. If you click on actions, you'll see options here to modify image permissions. And you can also change it to a public AMI. So I'm going to keep it as private. If I wanted to share it with another account, I could put the account number here. In this case, I'm just going to launch. I'm going to choose T2 Micro. And then this is where I have the option to change the availability zone. So let's put it in 2C. My original instance was in 2B. Let's click on next. If I wanted to, I could change attributes about the volume again here. And now I have an option to actually encrypt it. But I'm going to click on continue, configure security group, just go through and use my web access, click on launch and launch. So our instance is launching in the availability zone 2C, and it's going to be identical to the instance that we have running in 2B. So that's it. We have our instance running in availability zone 2C. It's going to be an identical copy of the instance we had in 2B. And normally you would actually modify your operating system, install your software, make whatever customizations you want, and then you create your golden image. That's your AMI. And that means you can then launch identical instances from that golden image. So that's how you might use AMIs in the real world. In this case, we just wanted to move our instance from one AZ to another. Now that's all we're going to do for this particular lesson. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to terminate both of these instances, and then we can come down to AMIs. And if we want to get rid of this AMI, what you do now is you deregister it. So deregister the AMI, then it's gone. And then you can actually go to the snapshots, because remember, we took this snapshot of our volume, and let's just delete the snapshot as well, because that is actually using some space, so that would cost a little bit of money. And we should see now that all of our volumes are gone except for that IO1. So that was the extra volume we created in the last lesson. So let's just delete this volume and then we're all cleaned up.